So this all started when I met Dominik in 2012 in Ionapa in Cyprus. We were both working as musicians in the Irish bars that were there. So there was two Irish bars, two Irish musicians, except there was only one Irish musician because he's fucking German.
Guten Tag, mein Name ist Dominik Hruby. Ich bin in München, in Deutschland geboren, aber mein Herz ist irisch.
Born in Munich on the 28th of November in 1985. My dad used to be a medic in a big airplane company down west of Munich, and my mother was working as an assistant in a dentist's practice. I was 13 when I took my first drumming lessons. Drums was my first instrument, and I played in the Christian rock band in church. It was kind of a worship band, yeah. Like, we played youth services for the younger people, kept it all rock and roll, so to attract the younger population into church. I quickly got into guitar instead because I thought it was more handy because you can take it everywhere. You can sit down with the bonfires, impress the ladies, you know. When did my fascination with Irish music first start? That was at the age of 14 as well, when my mother took me to an Irish festival over here. It was my first taste of Irish music. Delicious. I personally got hooked on Cluas the most, I think, because they just sound so magical, mysterious, and like they just take you away. How did I discover Irish music while living here? Mainly I just raided the CD stores back at the time. Like I told my parents as well, like, whatever you want to give me for my birthday, just make it sure it's Irish music. And other people from the sessions gave me CDs to listen to. And I did really, really start off with listening to a triple best of album of the Dubliners. And the first song I actually practiced to was The Lifeboat Mona. Which Irish musician had the biggest influence on me? I would say I will stick to Christy Moore, because he was one of the first I actually learned songs by. Off. What's my favorite Irish song to sing? I'd say it would be Back Home in Derry for some reason. Can't tell you why, but when I sing that song, I again disappear from this reality and dive back into the old reality, or the other dimension, what you want to call it.
For Australia bound, we didn't all drown, and the marks of our fares we carry. In our rusty iron chains, we cry for winds. Our good women we left in sorrow, as the mainsails unfurled like the curses we've heard on the English and thoughts of tomorrow.
How did my Irish accent develop? How did my Irish accent develop, bye? Sure, I don't remember really. Here in Munich, there's a lot of youth hostels where I used to hang out, spend my time to meet backpackers and people from all over the world. And I somehow always got stuck with the Irish for some reason. Back at the time, Munich had a big Irish population as well from the 80s, like the leftovers, the workers, the builders. And they always attracted me for some reason. And matter of fact, I have a musical ear, and therefore I think I picked up several accents on the way. Like, I don't know what it is right now, but I used to have a thick Cork accent when we met. And like, I even had an Irish accent before I started playing Irish music. Got that for 250 in test book. Am I ever being made fun of by my German friends for the Irish accent? Not at all. They're actually, well, I wouldn't say proud, but they're more envious. Is that the word? Is that an English word? Yeah, envious. They're like, I know a lot of Germans that play Irish music, and they always said like, oh, I wish we could have you as a singer because you actually sound Irish. And we can't really do the accent. But that's the thing. You're not supposed to play an accent. You're supposed to either have it or not. There's so many German Irish bands, but they sound like this when they sing. They have no Irish accent, and it just sounds like crap. Where did the name Cluas come from? Funny story. I was living in Brussels at the time and started playing actively in a couple of local pubs and different stages with a girl from Tullamore. Her name was, or is, Karen McHugh. She played the tin whistle and I played the guitar and sang. And our first proper gig together, we stood on stage and did the sound check, and it brought back a massive feedback, like this huge screeching sound, you know. And we both thought we lost our hearing. And she said, let's call ourselves Cluas. I'm like, oh yeah, Clueless, yeah, because I have no idea what to do with the sound system, right? She's like, no, Cluas is an ear or hearing. And I thought, that's spot on, and that's how it was born. And that was in 2010.
So you do know what Cluas translates to?
I do, yeah. In Irish. It also means listen, does it?
No, Eishtak.
Eishtak. Gav mal eishkil, Tony. How did I learn the Irish that I know? It's only a couple of fuckle. Do I have Irish tattoos? I do indeed, yeah. I have a shamrock here, which I got done in Ionapa. Quite funny walking around America with that, because that's also a symbol for the Aryan Brotherhood, which is a very, very bad gang over there. But nobody actually saw it. And I have the Guinness harp on my left shoulder. That was my first tattoo. And I have an Irish warrior on my left, on my right shoulder, with the tricolour waving behind him. Do I ever think I regret those tattoos? Never. Not a chance. It's part of my life, and they're under my skin. Did I live in Ireland actively? Yeah, I did. I was there in 2009 for, was it 10 months maybe? I flew over on the, I remember the date. It was the 4th of February. Or was the 2nd of April? Anyway, I flew into Dublin. How did it feel when I first stepped on Irish soil? Electrocuted. It was a rough landing too, because it was very windy that day, and the runway apparently was full of ice, and the plane slipped a bit to the side, and I thought, oh jeez, first time in Ireland, I'm going to die. Brilliant! went after the plane, and it was, back in the day, there wasn't those tunnels that connected to the doors, but it was like the stairway down onto the runway, the tarmac, and I went down those stairs, and I was like, I'm here. I put the foot down and I felt like something really, really going through me. Like, I felt like I need to kneel down and kiss the ground or something. Like, I really thought then I was home. First time, like, this is where I have to be. The 1916 Rising, for some reason, which I can't explain, and I gave up thinking about it, has a very deep connection to myself. Did you ever have the feeling you lived before, or you were somewhere before? That's how I felt when I came to Ireland the first time. I thought I'd been there before. And every time someone's telling me stories about the Rising and the General Post Office and Michael Collins and the Easter Rising, I felt like I was there, at least nearby, around the time it happened. O'Connell Bridge always had a big impact on me. Every time I crossed that bridge, I can't even remember crossing, and that was every single time I walked across that bridge. Everything kind of faded out, and I was just walking across, and then I was back there on the other end. I felt like I was there before, definitely. I remember that couple from America that asked me directions, and I was languorous, drunk that night. And I told them directions, and I told them the exact directions, but not like the main streets, but back alleys and stuff like that, where I've never actually been before. I just showed them, described them how to get through to where they wanted to go. And I realized afterwards in the hostel, looking at a map, that I've never actually been there, as I remember. But for some reason, I gave them the directions through the back alleys to where they needed to go. Did I visit the GPO? For some reason, I never really knew where it was located. Yeah, as I said before, I do believe I've had some time in Ireland before this life, and this is what I think I remember. Being a fighter, being a member of an uprising or something like that. Rebellion. Do I think I was Irish in a previous life? Certainly, for some reason. I mean, no one can prove it, but I do believe I was there before. Nobody can prove I weren't either. But that's the thing, we'll never know. Not in this life, anyway. Fuck's sake.
I was born in the Dublin street, where these loyalists drummed the beat, and these loving English feet, they marched all over us. And every single night, when me dad might come home tight, he'd invite the neighbours out with this call. Come out, you black and tans, come on and fight me like a man. Show your wives how you won medals down in Flanders. Tell her how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely lanes of Kelly Shandra. So come tell us how you slew them old Arabs two by two, like the Zulus, their spears and bows and arrows. Oh, how brave did you slew one with your 16-pounder gun, and you frightened them natives to their marrows. Come out, you black and tans, come on and fight me like a man. Show your wives how you won medals down in Flanders. Tell her how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely lanes of Kilishandra.